Hello everyone and welcome back to my playlist of biochemistry which we are doing from Satya Narayana textbook of biochemistry enzymes ka chapter hum discuss kar rahe hain and today's video will focus on the factors which affect enzyme activity. Ab dekhiye a very important concept for an enzyme to work is the contact between the enzyme and the substrate is the most essential prerequisite for the activity of the enzyme. So if I have an enzyme here, it requires a substrate to work on, yani jis cheez par ye kaam karega. So for example, we talk about amylase. So amylase will work on something, carbohydrate for example. If we talk about another enzyme called lipase, so it will work on lipids. So ऑब्वियसली जो एंजाइम्स हैं वो किसी न किसी चीज़ पर काम करते हैं और वो जिस चीज़ पर काम करते हैं उसे हम क्या नाम देते हैं, सबस्ट्रेट. द इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर्स दैट इन्फ्लुएंस द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द एंजाइम रिएक्शन आर डिस्कस्ड एज फॉलोज. तो अब एक एक करके हम ये बातें करेंगे कि कौन से ऐसे फैक्टर्स हैं जिससे एंजाइम एक्टिविटी फास्ट होगी, ठीक है, या अफेक्टेड होगी. सो द फर्स्ट थिंग एंड दिस इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड इज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द एंजाइम्स अवेलेबल. ऑब्वियसली जितना ज्यादा एंजाइम होगा उतनी एंजाइम एक्टिविटी इनहेंस्ड होगी. सो एज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द एंजाइम इज इंक्रीज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द रिएक्शन प्रोपोर्शनेटली इंक्रीजेस. इन फैक्ट द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द एंजाइम इज मेड यूज in determining the serum enzymes for the diagnosis of the disease. So for example, hum LFTs karwate hain. If we are suspecting liver problem, usme basically hum kafi sare enzymes bhi dekh rahe hote hain. Alkaline phosphatase hai aur dusre transaminases hain. So we are looking at the activity of the enzymes to identify ki unka action kitna zyada speed se ya kitna zyada acceleration ke sath ho raha hai. So the more the enzyme available, the more the activity. So if you see the substrate concentration, this one is actually showing the substrate concentration. I wanted to show you the enzyme concentration. So look at this graph for example. The more the enzyme concentration, the more the enzyme velocity. On the x-axis we have enzyme concentration. This is zero enzyme concentration, so the enzyme velocity is zero. As soon as you move to the next level, then to the next level, then to the next level, it keeps on increasing in terms of concentration and the velocity increases as well. Okay, right. The next thing that we have to discuss is concentration of the substrate. So pehli baat jo humne discuss ki wo concentration of enzyme tha, and now let's talk about the concentration of the substrate, yani jis cheez par enzyme ne kaam karna hai. So increase in the substrate concentration gradually increases the velocity of the enzyme reaction within the limited range of the substrate levels. और ये एक अंडरस्टैंडेबल बात है. देखो फॉर एग्जांपल ये मेरे पास सबस्ट्रेट है जिस पर इस एंजाइम ने काम करना है, ठीक है. अब सपोज मेरे पास एक फिक्स्ड अमाउंट है एंजाइम का और वो एंजाइम इस सबस्ट्रेट पे जाके एक्ट करेगा. सो एंड विद इन दी सर्कमस्टांसिस विदाउट चेंजिंग द अमाउंट और द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द एंजाइम, व्हाट आई डू इज चेंज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सबस्ट्रेट. इसको मैं इंक्रीज कर देता हूँ. सो नाउ मोर एंड मोर एंजाइम विल हैव द सबस्ट्रेट टू वर्क ऑन, लेकिन ये उतना ही ज्यादा स्पीड बढ़ेगी इस एंजाइमेटिक रिएक्शन की जितना एंजाइम अवेलेबल होगा. यानी देयर विल बी अ टाइम जब सारे का सारा एंजाइम यूटिलाइज हो जाएगा. अब चाहे आप सबस्ट्रेट की कॉन्सेंट्रेशन जितनी भी बढ़ा दें, एंजाइम वेलोसिटी नहीं बढ़ेगी बिकॉज ऑल द एंजाइम इज नाउ कंज्यूम्ड. आप समझे मेरी बात. सो दैट्स वाई द यू नो द ग्राफ इज लाइक दिस. सो इफ यू आर इंक्रीजिंग द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सबस्ट्रेट, सो फ्रॉम जीरो लेवल यू वेंट अप टू दिस लेवल फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एंड अप टिल दिस लेवल बाय इंक्रीजिंग द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सबस्ट्रेट द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द रिएक्शन इंक्रीजेस. इट गोज प्रीटी स्ट्रेट. बट आफ्टर दैट इवन इफ यू आर इंक्रीजिंग इट इज गोइंग एट सर्टन पॉइंट एक प्लेट्यू आ जाएगा. इस पॉइंट के बाद द वेलोसिटी इज नॉट गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. सो दिस इज वॉट इज वी कॉल द वी मैक्स reaction. So remember, if we look at the relationship of the enzyme concentration and the enzyme velocity, it's a straight line. But if we look at the relationship between the substrate concentration and the velocity, it's a hyperbola, and it reaches to a straight line, which means a gradual shift from too much increase of the velocity of reaction to then a stagnant situation. Ek plateau aa jayega, okay? And jahan ye plateau start hota hai, that is what we call the Vmax. Now, a rectangular hyperbola is obtained when the velocity is plotted against the concentration. Jo bhi humne graph dekha. Three distinct features of the reaction are observed in the graph. Number one, a linear. B is the curve, and C is almost unchanged. So if again look here, this is the linear portion, then there is a curved portion, this one. So that bit is called section A, this part is part B, and this is part C. So part C is the plateau, and part A is a linear straight line, and this is a curved line. Okay, if we further dive deeper, order of reaction, when the velocity of the reaction is almost proportional to the substrate concentration, the rate of reaction is said to be first order with respect to the substrate. And when the substrate is much, concentration of the substrate is much greater than the Km value, the rate of reaction is independent of the substrate concentration, and this is known as the zero order reaction. So if the rate of reaction is dependent on the substrate concentration and it is proportional to the velocity of the reaction, that is what we call the first order. When it is independent, it is zero order. And it usually happens in those scenarios where there is no effect of increasing the substrate concentration on the enzyme speed. Now, enzyme kinetics and Km value, that's an important concept to understand. The enzyme and the substrate combine with each other to form an unstable enzyme substrate complex for the formation of the product. So if we have an enzyme, koi bhi enzyme hai, koi bhi substrate hai, wo ek intermediate product bana raha hai, which is known as enzyme substrate complex, and then ultimately we get the product. Kabhi bhi koi chemical reaction hota hai, so we get reactants and then we have got products. So reactant is case mein hai enzyme or substrate, or product is case mein ye ban raha hai. But there is an intermediate, which is what we call the enzyme-substrate complex. Achha, K1, K2, K3, they are the velocity constants for respective reaction. Yani jo pehla reaction ho raha hai, jisme enzyme-substrate complex ban raha hai, uske forward reaction ki constant hai K1, aur backward reversible reaction hai, iska constant hai K2. And when the irreversible reaction from the enzyme-substrate complex, jisme product ban raha hai, uska constant hai K3. Now, Km is given by this particular formula. So now you know what is K1, K2, K3. So K2 plus K3, K2 plus K3 over K1 is Km. And the following equation for iske saath agar hum algebraic manipulation karein, so you need to remember that velocity of the reaction is the major velocity which you are measuring for any enzymatic chemical reaction. It's basically the Vmax times substrate ka concentration over Km plus substrate ka concentration. Okay, so remember this is a very useful formula. Hum aage enzyme kinetics ki jab baat karenge, so we'll talk about this equation in more detail. Let us assume that the major velocity is equal to half Vmax. The equation may be then half Vmax. So not going into the details right now, because we will talk about this later on when we discuss the enzyme kinetics. Now, Km, or the Michaelis-Menten constant, is defined as, yes, this is important, very important concept. Km is the substrate concentration to produce half maximum velocity. That's a very important point. Yani wo kitni substrate ki concentration hogi jis pe velocity half maximum hogi. So if you look at this diagram again, look at this picture, this graph will tell you what we are talking about. So where is the substrate concentration? Is the substrate concentration on the x-axis, and this is the Vmax. So Vmax is where jiske baad plateau shuru ho jayega. So is point par Vmax hai. Aur agar main Vmax ko half kar dun, so the half Vmax would be here. To half Vmax ko I am going to plot on the graph horizontally, aur phir ye niche x-axis par jahan bhi cross karega, ye wali substrate ki concentration kehlayegi Km. So Km is basically the substrate ki concentration jahan velocity of the reaction is at half Vmax. Okay? That's an important point. It indicates that half of the enzyme molecules are bound with the substrate molecules when the substrate concentration equals the Km value. So is point per exactly half of them are bound to each other, the substrate and the enzyme. Km value is a constant and characteristic feature of a given enzyme. Har enzyme ki apni separate Km value hai. To usse mein pata lagega kitni substrate ki concentration per half of the enzyme is bound. It is a representative of measuring the strength of the enzyme and substrate complex. Agar low Km ki value ki hum baat karein, so low Km value indicates a strong affinity between the enzyme and the substrate. Jiska matlab basically ye hoga ki bahut kam substrate ki concentration per half Vmax achieve ho jayega. So it's a very strong binding. So simply isko yaad rakhna hai aapne ki low Km means strong binding between the enzyme and the substrate, whereas a high Km value reflect a weak affinity between the two. Okay, for majority of the enzyme, the Km values are in the range of 10 to the power minus, so not important to remember. It may however be noted the Km is not dependent on the concentration of the enzyme. It is rather dependent on the substrate concentration or binding with the enzyme. That's what it is more important to understand. A KM value is indicative of how strong is the affinity between the enzyme and the substrate. Okay. Then there is another plot, Lineweaver-Burk double reciprocal plot. For the determination of the KM value, the substrate saturation curve is not very accurate. Since Vmax is approached asymptomatically by taking the reciprocals, I'm not actually discussing this right now because again, enzyme kinetics pe aage pura ek section hai, jisme main ye sari cheeze discuss karunga. Both these equations are important. Michaelis Menten's ki apni importance hai. KM value se aapko ye pata lagta hai ki substrate aur enzyme complex kis tarah kitna strongly ek dusre ke saath bind ho rahe hain. And then the Lineweaver-Burk double reciprocal plot tells you something else. It's actually the similar plot jo yahan ने डिस्कस किया था उसी का एक्सटेंशन है बट वील डील विद दिस व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एंजाइम काइनेटिक्स इन मोर डिटेल. सो एट द मोमेंट अब तक समरी क्या है? समरी ये है कि वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स व्हिच अफेक्ट एंजाइम एक्टिविटी. कॉन्सेंट्रेशन वॉज द फर्स्ट वन. ज्यादा एंजाइम होगा तो एंजाइम की जाहिर एक्टिविटी ज्यादा होगी. द वेलोसिटी ऑफ रिएक्शन विल बी हायर. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सबस्ट्रेट, द मोर द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सबस्ट्रेट, द मोर फास्टर इज द रिएक्शन, बट अप टू अ सर्टेन पॉइंट. आफ्टर दैट सर्टेन पॉइंट इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू मेक एन इम्पैक्ट एंड दैट पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड द Vmax वैल्यू. ओके. थर्ड फैक्टर विच कैन अफेक्ट द एंजाइम रिएक्शन इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर. Velocity of an enzyme reaction increases with increase in temperature up to the maximum and then declines. A bell-shaped curve is observed. So this is the effect of temperature on a chemical reaction. Initially, when you increase the temperature, it goes up. The reaction velocity goes up. So on x-axis, we have temperature. On y-axis, we have enzyme velocity. You increase the temperature from 10 to 20 to 30 to 40, it goes up. But after certain temperature, it then falls down. Okay? Right, temperature coefficient or Q10 is defined as increase in enzyme velocity when temperature is increased by 10 degrees centigrade. For a majority of the enzyme, Q10 is between 0 degree and 40 degree. Q10 is 2. So basically, isko I'll have to spend some time here. So let's go back here. Q10 is what? Ye aapko concept samajhna zaruri ki Q10 hota kya hai. Dekhen, it is defined as increase in enzyme velocity when the temperature is increased by 10 degree centigrade. Yani jab aap is graph pe agar hum dekhen, agar aap temperature ko 10 degree se 20 degree kar rahe ho to aapne kitna increase kiya temperature ka? 10 degree. Ab is 10 degree increase mein enzyme velocity kitni badi? So usually enzymes ke liye it's 2 value hoti hai. Yani Q10 is double the velocity of the reaction if the temperature is between 0 and 40 degree centigrade. Every 10 degree increase per Q10 ki value 2 se change hoti hai. इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर, सो यानी यहां पे जितनी भी एक्टिविटी होगी 10 डिग्री पर जो भी एंजाइम वेलोसिटी होगी वो 2 के फैक्टर से चेंज हो जाएगी जब 20 पे आएगा, वो फिर 2 के फैक्टर से चेंज हो जाएगी जब वो 30 पे आएगा, वो फिर 2 के फैक्टर से चेंज हो जाएगी जब वो 40 पे आएगा. दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज एन इंक्रीज. बट आफ्टर द टेम्परेचर ऑफ 40 इट देन फॉल्स डाउन. ओके. इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर रिजल्ट इन हायर एक्टिवेशन energy of the molecules and more enzyme collision happens. Obviously temperature se jo molecular sare structures hain unme collision badh jata hai, so reaction becomes faster. The optimum temperature for most of the enzyme is between 35 and 40 degrees centigrade. However, a few enzymes such as tag DNA polymerase, PCR jo log karte hain unko pata hai, they are active even at 100 degrees centigrade. And that's the beauty of this enzyme tag, because PCR reactions mein molecular reaction hai. Ye molecular biology wale students padhte hain isko bahut detail mein. Jab hume PCR reactions karne hote hain, so we use a machine which is known as thermocycler. Us thermocycler mein we raise the temperature up to 100 degrees centigrade intentionally, ताकि डीएनए के जो स्ट्रैंड्स हैं वो सेपरेट हों एक दूसरे से और फिर वो अनील हों एक दूसरे के साथ. तो इस प्रोसेस में वी हैव टू रेज द टेम्परेचर टू 100 और उस 100 डिग्री पे भी फिर ये एंजाइम काम कर रहे होते हैं. सो यूजुअली एंजाइम्स वर्क बेस्ट एट 35 टू 40 डिग्रीज, बट दे ऑल्सो वर्क एट अबाउट 100 डिग्री. देयर सम एक्सेप्शंस. ओके. दिस मे बी ड्यू टू वेरी स्टेबल एंजाइम स्ट्रक्चर ऑब्वियसली. In general, when the enzymes are exposed to a temperature above 50 degree, they denature, because enzymes are made up of proteins, so they denature with increased temperature. Foods can be preserved in refrigerators due to reduced bacterial enzyme activity. ठीक है, दैट्स द पॉइंट. कभी सोचा कि 4 डिग्री जो कि फ्रिज का टेम्परेचर होता है, इसमें खाना रखते हैं तो क्यों खराब नहीं होता, बाहर रखते हैं क्यों खराब हो जाता है? बिकॉज रूम टेम्परेचर होगा समवेयर बिटवीन 20-25 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. इसमें आपके खाने की प्लेट है, उस खाने की प्लेट में कोई ना कोई बैक्टीरिया होगा, उस बैक्टीरिया से एंजाइम बनेंगे, दे विल डिस्ट्रॉय द फूड. लेकिन अगर आप 4 डिग्रीज पर रख देंगे सो द एंजाइम्स विल नॉट बी वर्किंग, देर विल बी लो एंजाइमेटिक एक्टिविटी एट दिस टेम्परेचर एंड therefore your food is preserved. Okay, certain surgeries are carried out by lowering patient's body temperature. This is known as induced hypothermia, ताकि उनका metabolic rate कम हो. So temperature के effects enzyme activity पर. 40 degree तक it will increase the velocity of reaction. After that it may denature the enzymes. Now next we have to discuss what is the effect of pH. Increase in hydrogen ion concentration, which is what we call the pH, the hydrogen ion concentration, considerably influence the enzyme activity in a bell-shaped manner. Just temperature ka curve tha. Each enzyme has an optimum pH to work. Usse niche aur usse zyada agar pH hogi, to enzyme will not work fine. Most of the enzymes of higher organisms show optimum activity at neutral pH, which is somewhere around 6 to 8. There are, however, many exceptions like pepsin. Stomach mein hota hai, zahir hai. तो ये एसिडिक एनवायरनमेंट में काम करेगा. एसिड फॉस्फेटेसिस देखें एसिडिक पीएच पे काम कर रहे हैं. एनीथिंग बिलो 7 इज एसिडिक पीएच. एंड देन वी हैव अल्कलाइन फॉस्फेट, इसका नाम ही अल्कलाइन है, सो इट इज वर्किंग इन एन अल्कलाइन एनवायरनमेंट. ओके, हाइड्रोजन आयन इन्फ्लो. और अगर इसकी हम डायग्राम देखें, सो लेट मी फाइंड वेयर इज द डायग्राम. दिस इज द पीएच डायग्राम. सो ऑन एक्स एक्सिस नाउ वी हैव द पीएच वैल्यू. And at optimum pH, you see, if this is the optimum pH, her enzyme ki alag alag hogi. If this is the optimum pH for enzyme A, to is enzyme ki peak activity hogi at optimum pH. Agar optimum pH se kam hogi pH, to bhi dekhen activity down ho rahi hai. Aur optimum pH se zyada hogi, tab bhi activity down ho rahi hai. So in order for an enzyme to work best, it has to attain the optimum pH. Okay? Now, effect of product concentration. The accumulation of reaction product generally decreases the enzyme velocity. And that is a general rule. Dekhen, enzyme hai, uska substrate hai, aur ultimately kya cheez ban rahi hai? Product. Jitna zyada product banega, utna ye wala part jo hai, suppress hoga. So, more the product you make, the reaction goes slow. That's a general principle, okay? For certain enzymes, the product combined with the site, so not important. Effect of activators, this is important. Now, some of the enzymes require certain inorganic metallic cation, such as manganese hai, magnesium hai, zinc, calcium, all these sort of things, okay? And by presence of these, cations, the activity of the enzyme basically is enhanced because they make an enzyme substrate metal complex. There are two categories of enzymes requiring metals for their activity. Or wo kaun kaun si categories hai? Number one, metal activated enzyme. Metal is not tightly held by the enzyme and can be exchanged easily with other ions such as ATPase. Ek enzyme ki example hai, enolase. And then there are metalloenzymes. These enzymes hold the metals rather tightly, which are not readily exchanged. So basically, ye jo do categories hai, ho ye raha hai ke enzymes ke saath metals combine ho rahe hai. So if they are tightly bound to them, metalloenzyme. If they are loosely bound to them and they can be exchanged, they are metal activated enzymes. So ye do categories aapko pata honi chahiye, inki examples aapke samne likhi hai, okay? Right, now effect of time. Under ideal and optimal conditions, like pH bhi thik thak hai, temperature bhi optimal hai, the time required for an enzyme reaction is less. It will happen quickly because the conditions are optimal. Variation in the time of the reaction are generally related to alterations in the pH and temperature. Suppose ye lipids hain jisko mujhe digest karna hai by using an enzyme lipase. Ab ये तब काम करेगा ना जब पीएच भी ठीक होगी, जब टेम्परेचर भी ठीक होगा. इफ ऑल द कंडीशंस आर ऑप्टिमल, इट विल टेक लेस टाइम. ओके, इफेक्ट ऑफ लाइट एंड रेडिएशन. एक्सपोजर ऑफ एंजाइम्स टू अल्ट्रावायलेट, बीटा रेज, गामा रेज, एक्स रेज इनएक्टिवेट सर्टेन एंजाइम्स बिकॉज विद इन द एंजाइम स्ट्रक्चर देयर आर यू नो unstable structures which are formed. For example, ultraviolet radiation inhibit the salivary amylase activity. So radiations are in general not good for your enzyme activity, okay? So that's pretty important to know different factors which are important for enzyme activity. I'll see you in another topic of enzymes very soon. Take care of yourself.